Okay, so this morning, I will just continue my series on Genesis. Pero this time, the way I'll deliver it is quite different. No, I will not do an exposition of the passages we will cover in this two-part sermon. Okay, I'll finish this atuang Christmas party next week. Pero today and next week, we will be covering Genesis 12 to 25. Okay, and Genesis 12 to 25 actually covers the life of Abraham. Okay, so I sense the Lord wants to speak something to us from that, from those passages. And I prepared seven things. I sense the Lord wants to speak to us. Okay, so magtingala siguro mga nung seven, no? I read an article that sometimes ang mga speakers daw, they usually do 3 points, no? Sa ilahang sermon. Because ang kanang 3 points nga approach, kanang it's easy, no? For the audience, mas dali ma-digest. They can easily follow. But if ever daw you go beyond 3 points, no? Ang next number daw is 7. No. And then the next number I think is 9 or 10. So na siya. They did studies on that. So 7 akong himuon karon. Wapo mo po ng 7. It's God's number. Okay. So I'll talk about victory, no? I'll follow that theme of victory, no, in Genesis 12 to 25. And that is because, no, I just shared with you about the gospel. Diba? And I said nga ang gospel is a message about victory. The victory of God's kingdom. Okay? So, kana nga theme of the victory of the kingdom, ang ideas ana are embedded right in the 5 books of Moses, beginning with the life of Abraham. No? So, we'll follow that. And then the things I saw there, I want to declare it for all of us. I-declara nako. No? And I pray, it is my prayer that what we declare here will become real sa atong mga experiences in 2024. Okay, so excited na mo? Okay, so, pero before we go to Genesis 12, no, ato sang balikan in 1 Corinthians 15 because this is what I shared on when I shared about the gospel. No, ang ending 2 verses ana nga chapter sa 1 Corinthians 15 is 57 and 58. Paul said, but thanks be to God, He gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Okay? So, if you are in Christ, ang buot pasabot ana, you will also be victorious. Amen? Because you are in Christ. And Jesus has achieved the victory for us. So, kung nangalagad ta sa Ginoo in Christ, no, naagid kay expectation of being victorious sa imuhang Christian walk. Of course, we cannot perfect that. Di man nato na ma-perfect, no? Mu-fail man ta from time to time. Pero that is the principle at work in the kingdom of God, no? That the kingdom of God is always victorious and God's people are always victorious. Okay. So, because we are victorious, it liberates us and frees us to do the work of God. No mo ni nakanindot ana, because we do the work of God not as a compulsion, not as a duty, no, pero we do that because Christ has given us the victory, no, and the Holy Spirit will give us the joy, no, of serving the Lord. So mao na ang iyang conclusion, no? Victory man di ay in Christ. Okay, therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, stand firm. Okay, let nothing move you. Always give yourselves fully to the work of the Lord because you know that your labor in the Lord is not in vain. Okay, so nice sense din ha of a looking forward to the future. Dili daw vain, dili daw meaningless ang atong work dini, our work for the Lord, because we anticipate reward, no, in the age to come. Okay, so Pero kana tanan started no with the victory that Christ achieved for us. Okay, so let's look at those things that we can be, that I want to declare for us to be victorious over or victorious in, no, in 2024. So mubalik ta dito sa Genesis, no, sa life ni Abraham. Okay, so ang gospel, as I mentioned, is the good news about the victory of God's kingdom over all its enemies. No, the end will come down, no, when Jesus will hand the kingdom back to the Father after he has destroyed all his enemies. And the last enemy to be defeated is death. Okay? So, maunay giingon sa 1 Corinthians 15. And then all the enemies of the kingdom will be judged, pero God's people will be saved. No, salvation of God's people. And then part of the good news is the arrival of the king and of his kingdom. Okay, we are now living at a period of time in history where we are closer to the coming of the king. No, ang mga early church, ang mga apostles, they really thought Jesus would return in their day. No, pero wala siya ning balik in their day. No, nindagan pa og 2000 years and we are now at this point in history. So closer na ang return ni Christ than it was sa ilaha, no, 2000 years ago. Okay, so if you are a believer, no, that should be a reality for you as well. Okay, so kung real gid na sa imo, no, it will change the way you live your life today. Okay, pero kung kuan ra na academic ra na sa imo, then on Sunday we say yes, mutuo ko ana, pero from Monday to Saturday, no, ang atong lifestyle would not be aligned to that reality. Okay, so mao na ang ato ang ginatudlo diri sa TGFM, no, we teach about the kingdom of God and the reality of its advance and its coming soon, kanang near nga arrival, ayang arrival soon, and its consummation, no, makonsummate gina siya at the end, at in the age to come. Okay, so mao na ang gospel. So for the people of God, there is victory and we are empowered to do the works of the kingdom. And live today. No, nag-live ta today for the age to come. No, we don't just live for today for ourselves. Para sa atong mga dreams and aspirations, atong career, sa atong family. Lahi ang ato ang worldview. If you are a believer, no, you have a different worldview. No, you are living for the age to come. Okay, so mao na ang mga realities na ato ang ginalakwan, no? And these ideas are prefigured and foreshadowed in the life of Abraham, our father of faith, no? Sa Genesis 12 to 25. Abraham's life apply to us, no? Kang Abraham man to, no, sa may labot niya sa ato, it applies to us according to Saint Paul, no? So ngano daw, because we are the children of Abraham by faith. Okay? So that's what Paul says, no, in Galatians chapter 3 verse 7. Understand then that those who have faith are children of Abraham. No, you tell yourself, I am a descendant of Abraham. Spiritual descendant of Abraham. Okay? So what we will talk about today applies to you. No, if it applied to Abraham, it will apply to you as well because you are a child of Abraham by faith. Okay, klaro na siya nga pagtulunan, no, in the New Testament. Okay, so therefore, gusto ko mo declare of victory para ka nato tanan. Amen? So dawato nato na, no, karon nga year. So let's look at seven areas, no, which I feel God wants us and God will help us. God will enable us to be victorious over and victorious in. Number one, no? Victory over our selfishness and self-centeredness. Okay, mauna si gyud siya ang human nature. The fallen human nature. That's who we are. That's what the Bible says about man. Okay? Now dito sa world, no, lahi ang ilahang concept of man, no, because lain-lain man ang mga philosophy ana, no, pero out there humanism tells us that man is basically good and man will continue to progress, no? Pero ang Bible tells us that man is broken. No, man is separated from his creator. Okay? Man is a broken image of the creator. Okay? We need to be saved. No, mauna ang teaching sa Bible. We need redemption. Okay? So mauni, no, nga ang tao by nature jud, if you are not in Christ, even gani kung in Christ na ka, mulutaw gihapon ni. Di man ni mawala naman ni. No, we will get rid of this when Jesus returns, no, sa glorification. Okay, so tanaw na sa nato ni. So I declare nga manubo ta by next year, no? We will become less selfish and self-centered in 2024. So tanaw sa nato ni. The Lord said to Abram, go from your country, your people and your father's household to the land I will show you. I will make you into a great nation, no? Grabe na ang promise. Kang Abraham ug sa imo, no? And I will bless you. I will make your name great. Okay? Promise na siya sa imo. And you will be a blessing. You tell yourself, God will make my name great. That's God's plan for you, no? God will make your name great. He will make you great. Not for your own sake, no? Pero to bless others, to be a blessing, and to give glory to God. Okay? So, dawata na, no, ang mga blessings, ang mga unsa na ihatag ni Lord ni mo, dawata na with gratitude. Okay? And expect more. Okay? Kay mo na ang promise niya. I will bless those who, kuyaw ni, kining verse 3, no? I will bless those who bless you, and whoever curses you, I will curse. Wow! Powerful na. Kulba na siya. Okay, and then of course, verse 4, and all, so na purpose for all these blessings, so that all peoples on earth will be blessed through you. Okay, so ang atong emphasis din he is that all peoples on earth will be blessed through us. Ang atong emphasis is not on our blessing, okay? Siguro, bisan Christian na ta, no, daghan gihapon Kristohanon nga ang ilang focus is receiving blessing from the Lord, no? So they come to church every Sunday, pero ang ilaharag yung mindset is to receive blessing from God. Okay? We need to outgrow that. Okay? Kay si Christ did not live like that. No? When Jesus came on earth, that was not his mindset. Lahi ang yang mindset ni Jesus. No? He lived for the Father and for others. No? Mauna ang mindset ni Jesus. So if you're a follower of Jesus, we need to outgrow ang atuang selfishness of self-centeredness and become more and more like Christ. Okay? Amen? Makarelate mo, ani? Okay. You just ask my wife, no? About how selfish I am and self-centered, no? Kanang inanagid ang human nature, no? So we are all a work in progress, okay? So great blessing and power promised to Abraham, daghan kaayo, no? Kuyaw na ng mga blessings and promises kana, but ang gusto sa Ginoo nga iyang fokusan is for him to be a blessing to all nations, no? He was not to obsess about getting blessing and hoarding blessing for himself and for his family. Okay, maugi ni ang trap for many Christians, no? Now that we are in Christ, may experience na to ang blessing, no, we tend to just focus on getting more and more blessing and hoarding it for ourselves. Amen? I declare to you, you will outgrow that in 2024. Amen? Okay, the Spirit of God will work in our lives, no, sanctify us so that we grow into Christ likeness. Amen. So i-shift na to ang mindset, no? No, the longer you stay in TGFM, we want you to shift your mindset about what it means to follow Jesus. Okay. So selfishness and self-centeredness is our problem, huge problem na karon. Okay? I read an article, no, from Christianity Today magazine. No, put away childish narcissism. no, by Jen Wilkin. Interesting kayo ang iyang gisulat dito. No, so ingon niya, magkuha lang tag mga excerpt, no. No impulses run more counter to the biblical admonition to love our neighbor as we love ourselves than the twin cultural idols of individualism and instant gratification. That is so true in today's world. Okay, Christian parents, so nag-admonish siya sa mga parents, if you are searching for a simple way to be countercultural, here it is. Train your children toward shared identity and self-sacrifice. Maunay nakanindot sa body of Christ, no? Because we are not to operate as individuals only. You retain your individuality in the body of Christ, pero you also receive a new corporate identity, a shared identity with the people of God, no? And then, tudluan ta, and the church helps you learn that, no? To live a corporate life, okay? Corporate living, no? Church living. Fellowship with the people of God, the community of God's people. Okay? So, she continues to say, individualism says that I can and should do what's best for me regardless of what's best for others. And instant gratification assures me waiting is not a discipline to embrace, but rather an enemy to eliminate. Okay? Gitudluan, gi-condition mangguta for instant gratification. No? Instant na biya tanan. No? Tanan. No? So, dili natakaayo patient, no? To wait. And gusto ginato instant gratification. Okay? At every turn, I am told that I can and should have what I want and when I want it. I am offered goods and services customized not just to my own preferences, but to my values and beliefs as well, no? So, kuan yun, the customer is always right, yun. Okay, not surprisingly, kininga twin idols account for a sharp rise in narcissism, one that psychologist Jean Twenge has dubbed the narcissism epidemic in our modern day, today. Amen? So you see that everywhere. Mabitaw sikat kaayo ang TikTok, okay, or ang mga social media, no, because ang mga social platforms, that's where people can also advertise themselves, no, promote themselves. Okay? So, ang social media, dili man na siya evil, no? Neutral na, no? It's how we use them, no, that create kung unsay kuana na nila, no, value ana nila. Okay? So, kini, no? Nag-istorya lang ang ato ang author, no? About their encounter sa iyang husband. Nag-encounter sila og isa ka tao nga selfish kaayo, no? Grabe ang demanding kaayo, no? Whatever she wants it right now. Okay? Mo-demand yun. In fact, this girl, si Charlotte, no, demanded 24/7 of their time. Kasi si Charlotte lived with them, 24/7 yun ang gidemand ni Charlotte sa ilahang time. Okay? Pero you know what? Ingon niya, we didn't mind it. No? Ngano man, kay si Charlotte, mo man na. No? That's their new granddaughter, no? Si Charlotte. Okay? Okay? And her age-appropriate focus is to declare me right now. No, that's the appropriate focus of infants, no? Because infants should survive, no? So for them to survive, mo gina ang ilahang focus. Me, right now. No? So 24/7, alagae ko ninyo. Okay? Tama ba? Okay. So an infant demands what it wants and when it wants it, and rightly so. Babies self-advocate as a survival instinct. Pero an adult, lahi na. So ang adult, mo demand na gani na og imong attention 24/7, something is wrong. Especially kung healthy siya, dakog lawas. Okay. An adult who demands what he wants and when he wants it is a costly presence in any community. He only wants to prioritize his needs above those of others and of the group. Okay, he has not learned to put away childish things. Amen? Now, sadly, spiritually speaking, this is also true in the church. No, kay Christians can be serving the Lord for a long time. No, mukhang tanaw nimo sila babe, adult na, pero spiritual babes pa dai gihapon. Okay, so mao na ang admonition sa ato. I-outgrow nato na. Amen? I-outgrow nato na so that we can do what the Lord wants us to do. Okay, so mauni, no? God wants us to grow spiritually like newborn babies, crave pure spiritual milk so that by it you may grow up in your salvation now that you have tasted that the Lord is good. No, in fact, sa Hebrews 5:12, in fact, though by this time you ought to be teachers, you need someone to teach you the elementary truths of God's word all over again. You need milk, not solid food. No, anyone who lives on milk, being still an infant, is not acquainted with the teaching about righteousness. So, nay expectation sa word of God that we grow spiritually, no, and leave behind milk. Amen, and grow towards maturity. Amen. So in 2024, no, atuan ang ipagpray that we outgrow that. God wants us to grow spiritually. God's people are to live for God and for others. We are to put God and others first. Jesus came to serve and to sacrifice himself for us. You will find money ang secret actually sa happiness, sa significance, o sa purpose and meaning sa kinabuhi. Okay? The world tells us that to be happy and to find meaning, no, you pursue what you want to pursue. Okay, pero ang Bible tells us nga ang secret ana is not in selfishness and self-centeredness, but it is in seeking God first and seeking His kingdom first. Amen. So mauna ang una mga egsoon. So application, no, genuinely seek to know God more. Simple raman eh, practical man eh, no? Kabalo naman taan eh, no, di nagayon ako ni kinanglan ikuan. No, all of us know this. Join Bible studies, no? So ang uban ninyo din hi nga wala pa na plug in og Bible studies, we really encourage you. No, please, kung new ka diri sa church, next year mag-announce me, no? Maghimutag mga Bible study grouping next year so that all of you can be plugged in, no? So naka-organize na mi og Bible study groups and Bible study leaders, no? So amo nang i-announce next year. No, enroll in church seminars and courses, no, to help you sa imuhang spiritual growth. Amen. Number two, over more powerful foes and giving glory to God. Victory over more powerful foes. Tagaan kag kadaugan sa Ginoo over things nga imong huna-huna dili nimo makaya. Okay, God wants you to move forward by faith. No, usually ang Ginoo dili siya mohatag og challenge that is easy for you or a challenge that you think you can do on your own. Usually ang ihatag ba sa Ginoo sa ato nga challenge are those nga beyond sa imong capacity. Okay, and we pray next year, no, God will give us victory over more powerful foes, giving glory to God. I'm not talking about people, no, nga kontra nimo. No, mga challenges na to sa life, okay, or whatever comes to you, what is offered to you. Usay mahadlo ka mo dawat, kay mo ingong ka, dili na ko na kaya. No, pero the Lord wants to tell you, no, you can, okay? So, i-challenge ang imong kaugalingon, no, to receive what the Lord gives to you. And don't kanang step back, okay? Genesis 14, no? So si Abraham, opo niyang nahitabo, isa ka story diri. There were four kings, no, that fought against Sodom and Gomorrah and with its allies, no? And then they went away. They also carried off Abraham's nephew Lot and his possessions since he was living in Sodom. And when Abraham heard, no, so upat ni siya ka powerful kings fighting against five kings. Unya si Lot belonged to the five kings. So ningdaog ang four kings, no? So they took captive every people nga na belong dito sa four kingdom, sa five kingdoms, and Lot was taken captive. Okay, and when Abraham heard that his relative had been taken captive, he called out the 318 trained men born in his household and went in pursuit as far as Dan. During the night, Abraham divided his men to attack them and he routed them, pursuing them as far as Hobah, north of Damascus. And he recovered all the goods and brought back his relative Lot and his possessions together with the women and all the other people. Okay, so mauna, four kings conquered five kings, two captives, which included Lot and his family. Powerful ni nga mga kings, no? So ang isa ani is King of Shinar. Shinar is Babylon, no? Dako naman nga kingdom ang Babylon ato nga time. Okay, ang isa ana is King of Elam. Dako na pud na siya nga kingdom, no? So these were really powerful kings. And si Abraham went against them, no, with only 300 plus men, okay? So imposible gito siya. Okay? Pero Abraham achieved victory, no, by the help of God, okay? So kato nga victory ni Abraham is a picture, no, of what God intends for his people. No, nga we conquer enemies greater than us, challenges greater than us. It's by design gid na. Inana gyud sa kingdom of God, mao gyud na ang design. Okay, because God wants us to always grow, okay? So defeated, no, ang upat ka kings and he recovered Lot. Amen. So mao gini ang design sa Ginoo, no? Basahon nato ni 1 2 3. God's people are meant to conquer foes more greater than themselves. Okay? So Deuteronomy 7:1, basahon nato. When the Lord your God brings you into the land you are entering to possess and drives out before you many nations, no, kini nga mga nations, seven nations larger and stronger than you, and when the Lord your God has delivered them over to you and you have defeated them, then you must destroy them. Okay, so mao gyud na ang principle sa kingdom, no? God will help us conquer bigger enemies. Amen. Nanay purpose nga, no? Okay, so some of you have achieved, no? So ang uban nato diri ato mga igsoon, naka-achieve mo og mga victory, no, recently sa inyong kinabuhi, no, nga mga tan-aw ninyo mura grabe, no, imposible gito, grabe gyud ang nahitabo, no, pero by God's grace, through the help of God, no, you were able to conquer them. Okay? That's just the beginning. No. So next year we pray, no, God will give you more, no, nga mga kanang mga challenges. Okay, nai purpose nga, no. Okay, so in our journey God will always lead us to foes and challenges greater than what we can handle in our own strength. He will always lead us to uncharted territories. Amen. And he will always lead us outside of our comfort zone. Amen. And this will teach us to rely on him and be dependent on him. Amen. Okay. So ingna imong kaugalingon, ako nang dawaton nga challenge. Uncharted territories. Outside of the comfort zone, no? This will teach us to rely on Him and be dependent on Him. And this will teach us to give glory only to Him. Okay, and that's what Abraham did, no? After anto nga victory, naday gihimo si Abraham, no? So tiwaso na to basa kato nga narrative, no? After Abraham returned from defeating, no, kato nga mga kings, the king of Sodom came out to meet him. Okay, nagpasalamat, no? And then Melchizedek, king of Salem, brought out bread and wine. He was priest of God Most High, and he blessed Abraham, saying, Blessed be Abraham by God Most High, creator of heaven and earth. Okay, and praise be to God Most High, who delivered your enemies into your hand. Then Abraham gave him a tenth of everything. Okay, so mo na ang gihimo ni Abraham. So unsa may ibot pasabot ana? No, nga he gave him the tenth of everything. And then it continues to say, The king of Sodom said to Abraham, Give me the people and keep the goods for yourself. But Abraham said to the king of Sodom, With raised hand, I have sworn an oath to the Lord, the God Most High, creator of heaven and earth, that I will accept nothing belonging to you, not even a thread or the strap of a sandal, so that you will never be able to say, I made Abraham rich. Okay, so unsa may punto ana, no? Unsa may nahitabo diri? Unsa may punto ana? So si ang gihimo din ha, Abraham gave glory to God, no, sa iyang impossible nga victory. Okay, and he recognized God as his king. How do we know that? Because he gave the tenth. No, sa ilang culture, no, sa ancient Middle Eastern nga culture, ang tithe was the king's share, no, sa ilang umahan, muhatag sila tithe sa ilang king. That's the share of the king. No, kung naa sila'y bounty, naa sila'y loot, no, from war, ang 10% ana ihatag nila sa king. That's the king's share. And that's what Abraham did, no, he gave the tenth to Melchizedek, the priest of the Most High God. He recognized that God is king, and Abraham gave offerings, nag-offer po siya through the mysterious priest na si Melchizedek. No, which the writer of Hebrews writes about, no? Si Melchizedek is a type of Christ. Some scholars even say that he is Christ himself, no? So lain-lain ang mga view ana, no? Pero Abraham gave offerings through Melchizedek, and he refused to take anything from the king of Sodom. Nganuman, he wants to declare that only God has made me rich. Amen. Amen. Okay, so mao na ang reason why God gives us impossible challenges. Amen. So atong i-take on igso, no? Ayaw kahadlok. No, just take on. Bago man isa ako, mahadlok man ko ani. Just take it on, no? Because it will give glory to God. Amen. So next year, inay mo ko galing next year, dawaton ako ang mga challenges. Amen. So remember, only ang promise, no? Kuyaw kayo na ng mga promises. Let's remember, we must give glory to God the King who is in heaven. And we declare this will become real in our experience in 2014. Amen. Hallelujah. Lord, we will be victorious sa mga exciting challenges you will give us next year. Ayog kahadlok, no? Number three, over sin and separation from God. No, this is another thing, na hitabo kang Abraham. No, many people say, kanang unsa man magin akong serve sa God, daghan akong sala. No, makaserve bagid ko niya. Yes, you can. That's part of the victory Christ has given all of us. No, nga dili na ka ma-oppress sa imong sin. No, because the Bible says, in Christ, you are already reconciled back to God. You have peace with God. No, even though kadaadlaw, makasala malagi gihapon ko, yes, makasala gihapon ka, pero you have peace with God. You are justified. Kung makasala ka, then just repent. No, makasala ka, repent, and come back to God. Rebound. Amen? So, si God gagawin ang pwedeng ma-rebound na to, no? Usahay ang mga ex, di nataka rebound. Pero si God, maka-rebound kita, pero may everyday rebound back to God. Okay? So that's how we walk, no? In Christ, rebound yun. Kaya makasala magid ta. Okay? Pero ang truth is, you are reconciled back to God. You have peace with God. That's why you can minister. No? You can serve God with peace of mind. Okay? So mao ni ang nakita ni Abraham. Tanaw na ito ni Genesis 15, no? Abraham said, You have given me no children. Lord, nag-pray siya, Uma ko'y anak, Lord, tigulang na ko. So a servant in my household will be my heir. And the word of the Lord came to him, this man will not be your heir, but a son who is your own flesh and blood will be your heir. He took him outside and said, look up at the sky and count the stars, if indeed you can count them. Then he said to him, God said to Abraham, so shall your offspring or seed be. Inana kadaghan sa mga bituon sa langit. Inana, tinuod Lord, hapit na bi akong mag 100 Lord. Ang akong asawa, 90 anyos na. Yes, Abraham, no, inana kadaghan ang imuhang descendants. What did Abraham, how did Abraham respond? Basahon na to, verse 6, 1, 2, 3. Abraham believed the Lord, and the Lord credited it to him as righteousness. Powerful kayo na nga statement, no? Kanang isa na siya sa mga pillars, no, of the theology in the New Testament. Okay? So, unsay gihimo ni Abraham? He simply believed what God told him. Gituuhan niya what God said to him. He believed it. And what did God do? God credited it to him as righteousness. Kuyaw, no? So, gi-credit niya as righteousness. Ang faith ni Abraham, mo'y gi-credit na righteousness. So, Abraham, from that point on, he was reconciled to God. No, he had peace with God. Okay? God considered him righteous. God declared Abraham righteous. Even though si Abraham, daghan man siyang sala, no? Badlungon man siya nga bana, no? Mabasa na to din karon sa next nga story. No, badlungon biya siya nga bana, si Abraham, no? Pero he had peace with God. He was, kuan, he was counted righteous. Okay? Importante ni masabtan igsoon. Kaya kung dili ka kasabot ani, you will always be walking on planet Earth with a heavy burden on your shoulders ba? Nga na kay guilt kanunay. No, nga wala kay peace with God. Okay? You need to be assured, no, of your salvation. No? So in the Bible, righteousness does not come from doing good works. No, klaro gina siya sa Bible. Dili ta ma-reconcile sa Ginoo by doing good works. That's not the way. That is not God's way. Okay, faith, sa Bible, faith, not works, is credited by God as righteousness to the person who believes. Okay, mauna ang doktrina sa Bible. Okay, the person is counted righteous. Ang theological term ani is justification. Okay, mauna ang term para ana nga concept ana siya nga truth. Okay, justification actually is a legal term, no? Naman tayo mga abogado di rin, pero kanang pulong nga justification sa New Testament, it's a legal term. No, it is something that is credited or declared by a judge. Pag declare sa judge, then mauna na. No. Ma-impute na sa imo when the judge declares it, it is imputed to you. Okay? So, sa unsa na siya nga paagi? By faith. Dili na siya by works. Okay? So, mauna ang teaching, no? Sa Bible. No? So, basahon na ito ni, no? So, gi-explain na ni Paul dire. Okay? Gibasa man na ito na ganina, no? Kining a verse. Understand then that those who have faith are children of Abraham. Basahon na ito dungan. Verse 8. Scripture foresaw that God would justify the Gentiles by faith and announce the good news in advance to Abraham. All nations will be blessed through you, no, from these verses. So those who rely on faith are blessed along with Abraham, the man of faith. For now, verse 10, dungan na nato. For all who rely on the works of the law are under a curse. As it is written, cursed is everyone who does not continue to do everything written in the book of the law. Okay, mauna, ma-curse daw. Kung nag-rely ka sa law, ma-curse noon ka. Nga naman, because you cannot follow everything. Pilago na ka hundreds ka mga balaod. Can you follow everything? Can you memorize all of them? You cannot. No? So when you commit one violation of even just one law, violator na ka sa law. Okay? So ingon ni Paul, if you rely on the law, you will just be cursed. Okay? Now, unsa man ang good news, clearly, no one who relies on the law is justified before God because the righteous will live by faith. The law is not based on faith. On the contrary, it says, the person who does these things will live by them. Christ redeemed us from the curse of the law by becoming a curse for us, for it is written, cursed is everyone who is hung on a pole. He redeemed us in order that the blessing given to Abraham might come to the Gentiles through Christ Jesus, so that, gibold na kuni, so that by faith we might receive the promise of the Holy Spirit. Kung ma-justify na ka by your faith in Christ, ang next ni mo nga step is to walk in the Spirit. No, ang ato ang pagkinabuhi through the Spirit na. Kay dili man siya by works. Okay? So, mauna siya. Okay, so kita, we sense daghantag sala. No? If you sense that, that's actually good. Okay? Kinsa nakasense ani, daghang siya sala. Ako. If you sense that, that's good. Bad news na, if you don't sense that anymore, delikado na. So kung muingon ka nga, daghan di kong sala, that's good. No. Pero, don't stay there. No, ang imong himuon, it leads to repentance. No, you just need to repent. No, and believe in Christ and give your life to Him right now. No, ihatag imong kinabuhi karon sa iyaha. Tuo ka din, dawata siya, ihatag imong life sa iyaha karon. Okay, and you will receive justification. No, mao to ang teaching ni Paul. No, unya, ingon po ni Paul, you will become a new creation. No, so lahi po na siya nga description. Sa John, ingon po dito, you will be born again. No, so, and then you start journeying in sanctification. Lahi po ning sanctification. Ang katong ganina, justification man to, karon, by the Spirit na you walk in sanctification. Okay. So, kana siya, no? And our glorious hope is the day of our glorification. No? So, mauman niya akong gisulti last time. Kini, no? Stages of the kingdom. So, karon, kumutuo ka kang Jesus, you will be justified. And then you start growing in Christ-likeness daily. Mauni atong daily experience. Either you walk in the flesh or you walk in the Spirit. And then if you sin, we repent and rebound. Okay? Ang atong hope, atong gihulatan is consummation. Okay? So mauna siya. Amen! Application, move on! Inay mong kaugalingon, I'll move on. Okay, I'll move on from my guilt, no, from my shame, no, from my kanang from the condemnation. Move on, igsoon, no. If you are in Christ, move on. Okay, so believe and receive the truth that you have been reconciled to God and your sins are now forgiven. Amen. Ang imong sala, past, present, and future, forgiven. Amen? Okay, say it after me. My sins, past, present, and future, forgiven. I am now reconciled to God. I have peace with God. Okay? So, kana, ibsoon, no? When you give your life to Jesus, you have peace with God, and you can begin walking in the Spirit and serving God and people. Amen. So, ato nang i-declare, no, in 2024, mas mulalum ang atong pagsabot ani. Ang imong assurance of your justification will grow deeper and you will receive a revelation that your sins are forgiven, you are now reconciled, pwede jud ka mo serve sa Ginoo. Amen. Without guilt and condemnation. Okay? Katapusan, intercession, no? Victory in intercession. Kamutanan, gaampo man, no? Daghantag mga prayer requests, di ba? No? So gusto na ko i-declare, next year, mag-breakthrough pagid ka sa mga answered prayers ni mo. No? Mag-breakthrough pa ka sa imong intercession. Mag-level up ang imong intercession. Nga, dili na lang ka mag-intercede para kagid sa imong kaugalingon. Usay na magutan, no, we just pray for our needs. Okay man na siya, no? Continue doing that. Pero level up, no? Expand it. No, start praying for others, for leaders, for nations, okay? Because that's what Abraham modeled for us. Okay, so naay tulo ka chapter diri sa Genesis nga ang gidiscuss dito is how Abraham was an intercessor for the nations. Okay, if that's what Father Abraham did, that's also true for us karon if you follow Jesus Christ. That's why the Lord wants us to have a breakthrough ni ini nga area. Amen. Okay, basahon nato ni Genesis 20. Okay, now ang nahitabo ni si Abraham lagi, maldito lagi nga ba na, no? He went to a country and he said he did not kuan, iyang gi-deny ba nga wife niya si Sarah, no? He just said sister na ko siya. No, and Sarah was very beautiful, so ang king atong country took Sarah, no? Kuhaon, i-appeal siguro sa iyang harem, no? But the Lord intervened, no, in behalf of Sarah. No, so Abimelech had not gone her. Wala pa siya nahilabtan ni Abimelech, no? So gikuan man siya, gi-confront man siya sa Ginoo, nag-istorya si Abimelech ug ang Ginoo, no? So Lord, wala man ako siya hilabti. Will you destroy my nation, Lord, because of this? Did not Abraham say to me, she is my sister? Kaluoy pud sa hari, no? And didn't she also say he is my brother? I have done this with a clear conscience and clean hands. Okay, and then God said to him in a dream, yes, I know you did this with clear conscience, and so I have kept you from sinning against me. That is why I did not let you touch her. Okay, so maluluyon ang Ginoo ani nga king, no? Pagan king ni siya, pero maluluyon ang Ginoo sa iya. Now, mauna ni. Okay, now, return the man's wife. For, unsa daw si Abraham? He is a prophet. Kuyaw na, no? Ibalik yung asawa kay kanang tawhana na propeta. Father Abraham is a prophet. Ikaw, unsa man ka? Anong lisod na naugawa sa inyo ba? Propeta po. Prophetic pud ka because Father Abraham was a prophet, no? Magtan-aw ba taglaing verse karon that all of God's people are also prophets. No, wala ko nagpasabot nga mura kag si Isaiah or Jeremiah, not like that, no. Pero you are a prophetic person, no, because you are a child of Abraham. Okay? So iuli because he is a prophet and he will pray for you. Okay? So ang prayer day sa prophet powerful. Okay? And you will live. But if you do not return her, you may be sure that you and all who belong to you will die. Kulba, no? Mautoy giingon niya kang Abraham, all who bless you will be blessed, all who curse you will be cursed. So, mawara na siya nga principle diha. Okay, and then Abraham prayed to God, and God healed Abimelech, his wife, his slaves, so they could have children again. For the Lord had kept all the women in Abimelech's household from conceiving because of Abraham's wife Sarah. Amen? So powerful ang intercession ni Abraham. Your intercession is also powerful. Amen? Usay mag-unaon na tabang nga ang pastora ang gamhanan ug pag-ampo. Okay. Ingna po di mo ko galingon, gamhanan akong pag-ampo. Because I'm a child of Abraham. Okay, so you start praying for one another. Okay, you start praying. No, ayaw pirmi pangitag pastor nga muampo. No, you start praying. Amen? Ingnay mong kagalingon, I am prophetic. My prayer is effective. When I pray for others, sige, God will answer. Amen? King, sumaw na, no? So kining ang mga chapters, no, narrates Abraham's powerful role as an intercessor for people, for kings and nations, no. He prayed for Sodom, for Lot, and for King Abimelech. Abraham was a prophet, no. Sumo na gingo din ha, no. God's people are prophetic. And some of us can be called into the office of a prophet. Some of us, not all of us, pero all of us are prophetic. Amen. So magsugod na kag ampuhan next year, sugod na kag pray. No, masakit gani imong silingan, ampuhi. No. Masakit imong boss, masakit imong co-worker, pray. In Jesus' name, no, and see answer God's answers to your prayer. Psalm 105, no, mo ni akong giingon, no. This is talking about Israel. Israel nga very disobedient and very unfaithful ato nga journey. Pero look how God describes them, no, when they were but few in number, few indeed and strangers in the land, they wandered from nation to nation, from kingdom to another. He allowed no one to oppress them. And for their sake, he rebuked kings. Do not touch my anointed ones. Do my prophets no harm. Amen. So muna, God's people are anointed. Ine mo ko galingon, I am anointed. Mo muna igingon diha. Okay. So, intercede. Muna niya itong application, no? Not just for your needs, no? Padayon tag-intercede sa atong needs. Walay problema na, no? Dili na siya sayop. Continue doing that, pero kanang i-expand na to, no? God wants you to have a breakthrough in your intercession because you are prophetic. God called you to intercede for other people, for leaders and kings, and for the nations. So you start praying. No, now na ako'y gidugang diri, no? So, please, prayerfully consider this statement nga akong idugang, because not everyone might not agree with this, pero mao ni ako ang ikasulti sa inyo, no? Watch the news. How can you pray for the nations kung wala kay idea what's happening outside, no? Usay magstruggle man gutang mutanaw sa news, kay depressing ba, no? Ma-depressed ta magtanaw sa news. Pero on the other hand, the news helps us pray specifically. Okay? So, maybe balansihon lang nato, no? Ayaw lang po nga tibuk adlaw na ka magtanaw news. Okay, ma-depress gid ka na. No, pero you pray. Pray for Israel. But not just for Israel, no? Pray for the Palestinians. Okay? Because God loves the Palestinians also. Okay? So, daghan kaayong gakahitabo sa kalibutan karon, and we need to pray. Amen! Okay, so in closing, no, mao man ni ang ato ang verse gibasa ganina. So ato lang basahon. Dungana nato, for I declare victory for me. 1 2 3. I declare victory for me in 2024 over selfishness and self-centeredness. Number 2. Over more powerful foes, giving glory to God. Number 3, over sin and separation from God. Number 4, in intercession for people, kings, and nations. Amen.